What are Windows libraries and how do they work? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. What are they? They're confusing. Libraries were added to Windows 7 and actually persist to this day, though they're not as obvious as they once were, probably because of that whole confusing thing. In my opinion, libraries do little more than add confusion. I personally avoid them. However, it is an interesting feature that can be useful if you know what they are and what they are not. Let's work a little on that understanding. Libraries were in your face in Windows 7, but not so much in Windows 11. In fact, in Windows 11, you need to make them visible before you can use them. Let's do that first. We're firing up Windows File Explorer here. We're going to the ellipses and then clicking on Options. Clicking on the View tab in that dialog, we'll scroll all the way to the bottom of the list, and you can see there is an item called Show Libraries. Make sure that that's checked. Click OK, and you'll notice now Libraries has appeared here on the left-hand pane in Windows File Explorer. If I click on it, I get, well, basically what we all used to remember as libraries: documents, music, pictures, and videos. I'm probably going to say this more than once. Libraries are not folders, even though they kind of act like folders. A library, say the music library in this default installation, is a view on one or more folders, more being the operative word here. Right-click on the music library, we use that for our example, and click on Properties. You'll see here that it shows library locations. In this case, it's only showing one. It's showing the default music folder, which happens to be C:\users, your login ID / music. Great. We haven't done anything. We're about to. Click on Add. This time, I'm going to create a folder somewhere else. I'm actually going to put it in the root of my C drive just because. I'm going to create a new folder called My Other Music. We'll hit Include Folder. And now you can see that there are two folders listed in the library. So far, so good. What does it mean? All right, we'll go ahead and close this. In that folder, on my hard disk, I am going to create a file in My Other Music. New text document, just because. And I'm going to say, this is in My Other Music. So we know where this file lives. I'm also going to go to the default music folder and right-click here and create another file. This is in the default music folder. Okay, great. Now, I want to make this a little bit clearer by opening up a couple of additional views. I'm going to have this top window looking at the music folder, the default music folder that was there to begin with. And this lower folder, I'm going to have look at my local disk, My Other Music. And you can see now that in this PC, local disk C, this is My Other Music. This remains the music folder that was there to begin with. All right, one more instance of Windows File Explorer, because this time we're going to go to the library. Libraries, music. Both files are there. The music library, in this case now, is a view onto all of the folders that I happen to make part of the library. The way we've done it is we've got the default music folder plus this additional music folder that I created in the root of my C drive. This is one place to access both. Why would you want to do this? Well, Music is actually an interesting case because you may have, for example, more than one collection of music, but you don't want to actually combine the folders for real. You want to keep them in separate folders. Maybe you've got Amazon Music and iTunes Music or something like that in separate folders. Well, this way, you can interact with both of them at the same time by making them part of the same library. Now, remember I said it's confusing. So far, it seems pretty clear. We have two folders plus a view on the combination of the two. All right, confusion number one. So this file here is called This Is in the Default Music folder. And I'm actually going to copy it because what I'm going to do is in that other music folder, in the one that is on my C drive, I'm going to create a new text document and give it the same name as this document. Boom. What does that mean? We have two copies of the file showing up in our library with the same name. Now, Windows 11, fortunately, makes it clear that these are in two separate locations. Previous versions of Windows, particularly 7, did not make it clear. You would have a very simple list of files by name, and you would see the same file listed twice. It was not clear in any way that they lived in two different locations because they were in the same library. All right, confusion number two. Where do files go? Remember, we've established that a library is not a folder, but it's a view or a way of interacting with the contents of multiple folders. But you can sort of treat a library like a folder. For example, you can copy files into the library. But if a library isn't a folder, where do the files get placed? So I'm going to, in the library, create a new file. This time I'm just going to go ahead and say it's a Microsoft Excel because for whatever reason. Now you'll notice it immediately went into the default music folder, the C:\users/username/music folder. Why did it go there and not somewhere else? That's a setting in the library. If I right click on music again, the library music, and I look at its properties, you'll see that the directories are listed with check marks in front of them. There are two different kinds of check marks. The only one you really care about is the plain green one. That means that this is the default folder in this library. So if you copy something into the library, it will, by default, go into this default folder. The green check mark with a couple of people there, that has to do with other users dropping things into your library. It's just not something that I think most people really need to care about. It's just not something that happens. You can designate any folder that's part of the library as a default location. You can have multiple folders listed in this library. With this green check mark, that means that it's this music folder, not my other music folder, that will get files that are copied into the folder. All right, hopefully that's a little bit more clear. Like I said, they are confusing, and that's one of the reasons I really do believe that they have basically quietly vanished from the forefront of Windows. But I don't really want to completely badmouth libraries because they can be useful. That's why I'm talking about them at all. The example that I gave you of having multiple music folders all over my machine, it might actually be convenient to create a new library, which you can do, or update the existing music library to reference all of those different locations. That way, that library becomes a one-stop location for accessing all of my music. Now, bottom line, Yeah, some are going to label me a Luddite, I suppose, for suggesting this, but unless you understand what libraries are and are not, I suggest you ignore them completely. Instead, focus on using the folders you care about directly. It'll be less confusing, and you'll know exactly where your files are. If, on the other hand, libraries sound interesting to you, and you now understand what they are and are not, then absolutely experiment, play, use them as you see fit. But again, if you're not sure, they are 100% completely safe to ignore, and that's what I do. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5571. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.